So, how do you find oneness and zeroness? And how does the transition from oneness to zeroness go on?
What's your name?
Manu.
Manu, oneness is simple. Oneness means that the central element of everything and everybody of this entire world is just one. Apparently there are diversities. Apparently he and he are different. But actually their element is one. Just as you have steel in a bridge and you have steel in a sword, but if you are a little intelligent, you will know that their element is same. And you have steel here and you have cobalt here, but you will know that their element is still one. Why? Because ultimately you have electrons, neutrons and protons within both. So the element is one. Just an example. Similarly, the element of everything that appears, be it wood or plastic, be it man or woman, is one. That realization is called oneness. Looking at it another way, we live in a dualistic world. We live in a world where everything exists only because of its opposite. So you have that whiteboard behind. If something is written on that whiteboard, what does that mean? Can you write on white with white?
No.
White and black must coexist. But whenever you are reading something, your entire mind is concentrated only on the black. So much so that you forget the white that is immediately and closely present. The intelligent mind says white and black are one. One cannot exist without the other. They are not two, they are one. Had they been two, then one could have existed without the other. But the fact is, one of them cannot exist without the other one. They are one. Similarly, happiness and sadness. You cannot experience happiness if you are not sad. You have to be sad in order to experience happiness. In fact, the more sad you are, the more happiness you can experience. Is that not so? Are we together? It's a prerequisite. Unless you are sad, you cannot be happy. So the wise man does not look at happiness and sadness as two things. We said when we are reading something here, then our entire mind is concentrated only on the black. We simply forget the white that is present behind, right? In the same way, when we are happy, then our entire mind is concentrated upon happiness. We totally forget the sadness that is accompanying the happiness. The wise man does not do that. The wise man knows that this happiness is definitely accompanied by sadness. So happiness and sadness are one. That one is the element that I am talking of. That one is the element of this entire world. This is called oneness. So oneness is to see non-dual in duality. Oneness is to see the non-dual in all duality. Oneness is to see the common element in all apparent diversity. Everything that appears to be different, I am able to see one common thing in it. That is called oneness. So the wise man who can see that oneness is not moved by pleasure and is not moved by pain, because he knows that pleasure and pain are
same.
He is not moved by ambition and he is not moved by fear, because he knows that ambition and fear are. When he looks at the day, he knows that the day is a little bit of an illusion. Why? Because there can be no day without the night. So he cannot be very persuaded by the fact that, oh, it's a great day, it's a great day. He knows that one side of the coin, the other side must be there, it has to be there. So he cannot be a pleasure seeker. He cannot be an ambitious man. He can never be attracted to one side of duality. That is oneness. Getting it? The stupid one does not see that. He thinks that happiness and sadness are different. The stupid one will say, I want permanent happiness. Now, can permanent happiness be there ever? Because if happiness is permanent, then it is no more happiness. Happiness needs to have sadness so that it is happiness. But the stupid mind will say, let me be happy forever. Let us be together forever. Can there be permanent togetherness? Impossible. So the stupid one suffers because he does not see that oneness. Only that oneness is permanent. Duality is never permanent.